Sound.
สวัสดีครับ Good day once again. This time I would like to speak a bit about my worries about the future course of Thailand. What stir me up a bit is the fact that as of last week, there were global news about the Samsung company of South Korea, as well as the Apple company of the United States, have both decided to move their factories out of China into Vietnam. Then the question that occurred in my mind is why didn't they decide to come to Thailand? Why do they go to Vietnam? Vietnam had just opened the country not long ago. It's still run by a one-party communist system. They are not as experienced as Thailand in terms of opening up of the country for export-led economies, for export-oriented industries, and so on. And we have been in the game of direct foreign investment, transfer of technology for a long, long time. But somehow lately, I think roads seems to go to Hanoi and not to Bangkok. What has been the problem for Thailand so far? I think we have to congratulate Vietnam in that sense, and not to be jealous of it, of being able to, I think, attract more of foreign business activities in the country. But it is a lesson for Thailand to relook at itself, to have the self-introspection. Why is it the case? Why aircrafts are flying across Thailand into Hanoi or into Ho Chi Minh City or Vietnam? And I think both Vietnam and Thailand and many other developed countries have similar set of privileges and tax incentive for foreign investment. But the differences between Thailand and Vietnam may be accounted on 2 points. One is the overall political stability, I think, which Vietnam, with the one party totalitarian system, could provide more stability. Thailand, sort of, you know, very much of an open society, of course, by implication would have more instability in the political processes and so on. But that is not as important as the fact that I think for me, I feel that Vietnam could offer manpower needed for factories and so on. And that skilled manpower or at the professional level, whether it's engineer, scientists, researchers, and so on, Vietnam seems to be in the position to cater to the interests and to the demand of foreign companies more than Thailand at this point in time. I think we have been taking things for granted, basking in the sun of past successes and so on, without paying much attention to the, I think, reform of the education system to put into practice the fund for research and development, and to be more self-dependent, self-reliant, instead of being dependent on foreign knowledge, know-how, research and development activities, and so on. And we cannot keep on basing our own economic development on export-led industries. It's about time that we look more into the domestic and regional markets, and using our own, I think, intelligence and know-how to produce products. Maybe not for export anymore, for domestic and for regional market, especially the ASEAN market, which I could consider it as more of a domestic market rather than international market. But in all of this, I think for the past 30 years, Thailand was being slated, or I think being named as a sort of a country with the middle income in the middle income trap, in the sense that we do not have the science and the technology, and at the same time our labor cost has been rising much higher than neighboring countries in Southeast Asia and in the Indian subcontinent. So the labor cost in Thailand is no longer competitive like it was 30-40 years ago, and when a lot of countries like India or even Vietnam were more or less a sort of a closed state-led economy. But lately they have opened up to the globalized world of a borderless and flow of investment and capital and so on. But Thailand has been staying a sort of a static, still dependent on foreign investment, technology and know-how, and the products are being distributed by the companies that invested in Thailand. But we have not had anything of our own that come from our own, brain power, from the skill of the Thai workers, the scientific and the engineering know-how. And what is more worrying at the moment is because for the next 8 months to 10 months and so on, the government would be too busy with the upcoming censure, debate motion, in the parliament on the 19th to the 22nd of July. And after that, I think every party will be moving out of their headquarters to looking for candidates for the upcoming elections slated to be at the beginning of the next year. But all in all, there has not been much, there have not been any news and so on. What each of the major political parties or all of the political parties has for the socio-economic development and transformation of Thailand into the model digital world economy and so on. So this is something, it's left much to be desired. So political parties have no right just to only, looking in terms of winning or losing elections. I think they have also the obligation to come out with a sort of a set of policy measures that would take Thailand out of this middle income trap and to become more technology-oriented society that could have the capacity to compete internationally, So this is something that is a cause of concern for me in particular, and I think for all of us and so on, that it's about time that we move away from a supply chain, move away from export-led economies, and to be more, domestic and regional oriented, and to have the products that come from the intellectual capacity or the creativity of Thai farmers, Thai workers, scientists and engineers, and from the researchers and so on. The most profound effect that I felt personally was the news last week that Apple company and Samsung company have both decided to move their factories out of China and replace them in Vietnam. Then the question that arose in my mind, why didn't they come to Thailand? And my initial answer is because Vietnam has, beside the political stability of, totalitarian control, but on top of that, I think they have more skilled workers, they have more engineers, they have more scientists and so on. And I think and their research institutes are quite progressive and so on. So foreign companies feel comfortable that when they come to Vietnam, they don't have to really go and search for skilled manpower or scientists or engineer. These are more or less quite available in Vietnam. But if they were to come to Thailand, they would meet a lot of difficulties. So this is a thing that I think political parties and the next government of Thailand must think very hard and come out with a set of policy measures that would make Thailand again competitive and at the same time more self-reliant in terms of scientific knowledge and technology know-how. So thank you very much. ครับ ขอบคุณมากครับ